there's something of a luxury for you, I suppose, insofar as this bill comes nowhere near what you would think would be required to put in proper services for Irish women.
Yeah, I believe it's a woman's right to choose, and I think we have to repeal the Eighth Amendment sooner rather than later in order to vindicate that right, and this legislation is very disappointing.
How realistic do you think that is? I mean, any referendum going with, you know, that just a woman's right to choose, would it have any chance of electoral success?
Yes, I think it would. And what's absolutely clear from the opinion polls is that the public, in their opinions on this matter, are way, way ahead of the politicians, with over 70% of people thinking that we should have the right to abortion in situations of rape, incest, or where the life of the mother is, or the health of the mother, not just the life, but the health of the mother is threatened, and an overwhelming majority as well believing that people should have the right to terminate pregnancies where there are fatal abnormalities, a pregnancy where the fetus has a condition incompatible with life. And I argued indeed today that even within the framework of the existing constitutional limitations, that issue at least could have been included, because there is no clash between the right to life of the unborn and the right to life of the mother in a situation where there's a pregnancy with fetal abnormalities, because the fetus is not a viable life.
I'll just go back to Sarah. Sarah, how realistic do you think is Richard's aspirations in that? That, you know, he would like to see a bill that would encompass all of those things: fetal abnormality, rape, incest, you know, the right to mother. Do you think if that were put to a referendum that it would have any chance of getting a majority in the country?
Well, as Richard had said, I mean, some of the polls suggest that there is support among the people, and quite substantial support. Now, I don't have the figures off the top of my head, but I think we're talking over 50% for all of those cases, I think. Now, I'd have to check that. Certainly, the support for fetal abnormalities or abortion in those cases is quite substantial in the country.
It is. You know, I think we have a clip today of that being discussed in